Blog Talk Radio.
MOF Radio. When you want to know what's up in the MOF.
Gentlemen, I firmly believe that any man's finest hour, his greatest fulfillment of all that he holds dear, that moment when he has worked his heart out in a good cause and lies exhausted on the field of battle, victorious.
We have sacrificed so much to not take the glory! Super Bowl, are we straight now, baby? We got a shot to be world champs!
Gentlemen, that moment is waiting on you. It's waiting on every man in the Steelers locker room. Waiting on every man in the Packers locker room. What separates the Super Bowl from all the other games is that a Super Bowl is always remembered. It's not just another 60 minutes of football. It's 60 minutes that can define you forever as a winner.
Ain't no tomorrow, man. Today is our day.
You know, people ask, is winning really the only thing? Well, my answer to them is my answer to you. Ask yourself the damn question. Is winning the only thing to you? Is it what you want? Do you want to be remembered as a winner? Or as something else?
That's for all the balls. That's what we play for. Right there.
Playing in the Super Bowl is about playing in a game that will define you forever. Make this game your finest hour. I'll be waiting for you.
Here we are, coaches, MOF Radio, Episode 5. We've went on hiatus last week, but we're back this week. This will be the last episode before we start the Season 23 playoffs. The number to call in is 646-595-3554 if you guys want to be a part of tonight's show. Hold on a second. All right, here we go. Something's going on here. All right, sorry about that, little networking problem. So if you guys want to be part of tonight's show, call the number 646-595-3554. We'll accept guests a little later in the show. So how'd you like that opening? Sent chills down my spine. You got to love this time of season. The playoffs coming up. Now, speaking of the playoffs, we're just about set. The Chiefs have defeated the Bengals earlier tonight, and he clinched that sixth and final season playoffs that eliminates Coach Aaron and the Dolphins. And I'm sure a lot of you guys are happy about that. Aaron will not be in the playoffs this season. And also, Aaron has declined an invitation for season 24. So it looks like we're not going to see Aaron again until probably September or so. So as far as the unknown spot, it looks like the AFC South division is still up for grabs. Now, before we break that down, as we all know, Coach Ucat retired on Sunday from the league, giving up his Titans. He was 7-5 in the first place. It's pretty crazy. But he left the league with a sorry bro, I'm out message through the PlayStation. So we've been going back and forth on this ruling about what to do with the Titans. Eventually what happened is yours truly took them over, but then I determined it wouldn't be fair for the rest of the league if I were to take the Titans to the playoffs. I mean, I already had the Vikings this season, so, you know, that really wouldn't be fair, especially since I didn't play a total of six games. So we did come up with a rule. So any coach coming in, either be a rookie, a veteran, or a coach that's currently in the season taking over a team, you got to play at least six games with that team to be eligible for the playoffs. So that's a new rule, and it's in effect immediately. So with that, the AFC South. Right now the Colts and the Jaguars are playing each other. So these two teams are not really neck and neck, but, I mean, if the Jags can beat the Colts tonight, the Colts will be 7-8. The Jags will be 4-8, and the destiny will be in the Jaguars' hands. If he can win out, go 8-8, he's going to win the division. So the latest update on that score was, I think, 28-14. I'm not sure in the quarter, but the Jaguars were up 28-14. It could be a third, could be fourth. Now, I sent an email earlier today about getting these games in tonight. But if the Jaguars stay alive here, I mean, he has five games to play. I think he might get another one in if he does win tonight, and hopefully we can get these in as fast as possible so we can start the playoffs. But what can I say? I can't really advance the season on him because he's coming back from a 1-7 start. So now, completely non-playoff related, I hope the Falcons really win tonight. He's finishing his season 0-14. He has two games against the Saints. I'm really hoping that he can pull one out. So, without further ado, I'm going to bring on my gorgeous co-host, Paulie. Paulie, you there?
Yeah, what's up? We're here.
What's going on, buddy?
Pretty good, man. Pretty good. How's it going? A lot of controversy going on in the last week here, man. Getting a lot of gray hairs over this shit.
Well, first, congratulations on your win. You finished season 13-3, and you locked up that second seed. Good job.
Yeah, man. Got to lock it up, man. Got to get the little rest of my plays, and got to get ready for the Jets to come on in here. So I'm ready for that.
Well, before we break anything down, I figured we discuss this Colts-Titans thing. It looks like we kind of disagree on what's going on here. So I guess the problem is you're having is the Jags. You know, he was missing for about a week, and I sent the email. Now all of a sudden he's back and getting his games in. I guess you feel like that's kind of unfair, right?
Well, even today he said he didn't respond to you, so I'm kind of thinking, you know, if you're going to be MOF, you're going to be MOF, you know, not take the week off, and when Kamish hits you up on an email, you're going to come back all of a sudden. This guy's been here. Colts have been here. He's lost. He's won. And he's here. So, you know, just give him the chance to be in, you know, in the highly coveted, you know, MOF playoffs. What else is there to live in life than the MOF playoffs? You know, just give him a chance, man. Now all of a sudden he's got to win some games under, in the last minute of the season, send an email out, the season's over, then it's back on, then it's over, then it's back on. You know, I have nothing. I don't even know the Colts guy. I just think he's a good guy. He stick through 0-5. Now he's came back, and I just think, you know, just give the guy a shot. That's all. That's all I ask.
No, I understand where you're coming from. It's definitely, I definitely hear you. But the thing is, the Colts dug his own grave. I mean, he could have been 8-7. He could have been 8-6. He could have just not even been worrying about this right now. But the fairness is the Jags took over. He's in the race, so we have to give him a chance. So hopefully the Colts can just come back and win this game right now and just end all the controversy and just make the playoffs himself.
I got you, man. I got you. I got a little something. Playoffs? You kidding me? Playoffs? I just hope we can win a game. There you go, baby. There you go.
That sounds like me. That's great. All right. So what I wanted to do first is just go down the standings real quick. Just break it down one last time as we close the season out here. So the first thing, the AFC East, locked up by the Jets. Good job by him, even though he kind of stumbled to the finish there. He blames it on the laggy game against the Bills, but he lost to the Bills, and he's kind of limping into the playoffs a little bit. But he still won a division, so you got to give it to him.
I got you, man. You know, the Jets are the Jets. You know, when we get into the playoff matchups, I hope we will. You know, I'll say a little bit more about my friend Alex there. But right now, good job, man. Good season. And good luck.
All right. Well, all right. So the North, the AFC North. You did think the Ravens were gonna pull it out there, but he definitely he choked down the stretch there, lost a huge game to the Raiders, and you ended up blowing him away and finishing 13-3, getting that second seed. So good job to you.
Yeah, you know, it was a tough division. Ravens were the best team. You know, I did what I needed to do to take it, and that's where I stand.
All right, and then we have the AFC South. As we know, the Titans have been deemed ineligible. So we got the Colts at 7-7, probably about to be 7-8, and then the Jags at 4-8. This, obviously, again, like I said, it's going to be, you know, obviously the four seed, whoever wins the South, is going to play the Raiders, and I don't know. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, I don't know. You know, I like the Colts guy. I think he's been there. Jags, you know, still coming into the league, and he's an all-star, but he hasn't, you know, been around enough to be in. But whatever, you know, whatever it is, it is. Just, you know, my man Dan over there in Oakland's kind of waiting, saying, what the hell's going on right now? Who am I playing? It keeps changing. So, Dan, don't worry.
Oh, I bet you Dan doesn't want to see the Jaguars, that's for sure.
I hope not, man. But, you know, Dan, I got you, man. You're a vet. I got the vets back, man. So, hopefully you make it through, man, no matter what.
All right. So, the AFC West looks like the best division in the league by far. We had three teams with 11 or more wins. The Broncos are 14-2. They clinched the first seed in the playoffs, and the Raiders at 12-4, and the Chiefs at 11-5. So that's a monster division right there, and all three teams have made the playoffs.
Yeah, you know, the Broncos, again, my pick to win the Super Bowl this year. You know, my pick, unless the Jets knock them off, but my pick to win the Super Bowl this year. Chiefs, I'll talk about you later. And, you know, Dan, you're my boy. You know, you don't know who you're playing yet. It's kind of hard. I don't know what's going on right now. It's kind of Mickey Mouse, but, you know, I got you.
All right, so now we move over to the NFC side of things, where the NFC East was won, I think, maybe by week two by the Redskins. The rest of the NFC East was just horrible this year. The Redskins cruised. But the thing is, though, the Redskins lost two games, and no one's really talking about it, but he lost to the Chargers, and he lost to who else? I forgot. He lost another game, though. The Panthers? No, he would beat the Panthers. The Panthers lost two games in a row, and what am I saying? The Redskins lost two games in a row. See, look at me. I'm confused.
Wow.
The Niners lost two games. what's going on here? Website not even open. I think MMX is up there on the website. Anyway. The Redskins lost two games. He's kind of limping into the playoffs, too, but I still believe in the Redskins. You have to.
Yeah, man. You know, I don't know. He lost to the Chargers. I just played the Chargers, so I don't know, man. Betts can beat the Bears. He was online labbing all day. I seen him, you know, when I got home, and I don't know if you are. I don't know if you're ready, dude. You gotta step it up for these this week if you want to compete with the best. You got to be the best, and you got to get ready, man. And losing the Chargers is not a good way to get in the playoffs. Your confidence is probably below my foot right now. But come on, get back up there, get on the horse, and cite those Bears, bro.
I'm sure they'll be ready when the time comes. And speaking of the Bears, they did finish undefeated. I called that, I think, way back, maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago. So he did finish 16-0. Now, the thing is, can he finish 17-0, 18-0, 19-0? Can he do it? I don't know. It's not going to be easy, but I think – I have to go with him, but he had a great season. And the Lions also had a very good season. They're both in the playoffs. And the Lions, he could be a dark horse. You never know.
Yeah, you know, my sexy wife was up there, and he was good, you know. He kind of made it. You know, it was between you and him, and he just pulled it through at the end. He's tough. He is tough. He'll maybe win a game in the playoffs. I don't know who he plays first round. We'll go over that later, but whatever. But as far as Vinny goes, you know, the Bears, I saw him online today. He's committed. That's all it takes. Be committed. Get your plays right. You know, get your offense going. Get your defense strong. And that's what he's doing. Come playoff time, he's in there. He's getting the work done in the film room. He's doing what he needs to do to be good. And I think he's going to be tough to beat in the NFC. I don't know. Maybe Broncos, maybe Jets. I don't know who else can beat him.
No, I don't know either. It's a crapshoot. But the last person that did beat him was Hugh Peasy. And he has won the South with the Panthers. And he's always a tricky one to figure out. The website shows he's the second seed, but he is not. He's the third seed. He will be playing, looks like, the Bucks in the first round, which is great. And the Bucks didn't make it. With the Saints, if the hockey fan would have stayed with the league, he probably would have made the playoffs. So we might have removed him a little prematurely, and I apologize to him if he's listening. But, you know, when I send an email out, I expect to hear something back. When I send text out, I want to hear something back. If I don't, you know, I'm going to replace you. I don't wait around. So the Saints are ineligible for the playoffs, so that's why the Bucks clinched.
Yeah, man. You know, you don't mess with Dipko, man. You don't mess with him. You know, he's a man with an iron can. You don't mess with him. So, you know, if you're not around, adios, man. You know, we got more to come. So as far as that division goes, you know, I don't know. I just, in the NFC right now, I don't see anybody else except for the Bears. So if somebody wants to step up, let me know, and I'll holler at you. But right now, I can't see anybody else even, like, sniffing, you know, them. But that's all. You know, I don't know what to think about that. I don't know.
As a quick score update, the Jaguars are winning 42-14, and it's almost the fourth quarter. So it looks like the Jags are gonna stay alive with that win there. So now we go to the NFC West. This was clinched by the Niners. The Rams had a nice strong showing at the end there, but the Niners did finish 11-5. Finished pretty strong, so he could be another dark horse. A lot of people are overlooking MMX, but I mean, you never know. You never know what's going to happen.
Yeah, MMX, you're a good website guy.
All right, so with that, I figured we break down the playoffs that are coming up. I know we don't know what's going to happen with the South, but at least we can break down the rest of the game. So. Let's get our playoff music going here.
Nice.
If you can hear that or not. But the first game we're going to break down in the wild card, it's going to be the AFC side. The Kansas City Chiefs, who finished 11-5, will be visiting the New York Jets, who are either going to be 11-5 or 12-4. This game is going to be great. I think it's going to be a really good game. The Chiefs won back in Week 8, 24-20. I really think that the Chiefs will repeat that, and they will win again. I'm going to pick the Chiefs to win 34-31 in a very close game, and you're not going to get your Alex matchup in the divisional.
I don't know, man. I think the Jets, man, you know, teams who prepare win in the playoffs, you know. The Chiefs guy, yeah, he's good, but, you know, he hasn't experienced the MOF playoff atmosphere, and that's what I think Alex has. He prepares. He knows the X's and O's. You know, he does what it needs to do to find what the other team's weaknesses. And I think this has a great team right now, and I think the Chiefs are going to get a little bit nervous in that matchup. And I think, you know, Alex wins by at least two TDs in that matchup. And Alex, you're my boy, man. You're my boy.
Wow. Okay. I think that's your heart picking instead of your brain. But you pick the Jets, I pick the Chiefs. That's fine. So next game would be the Raiders visiting either the Colts or the Jaguars. Now, the Raiders beat the Colts back in Week 1, a 36-35 game. What's interesting about the Colts is not many people know this, but he lost his first five games. So since then, he's been 7-2, it was going to be 7-3. But he's been one of the hottest teams in the league, and I think if these two play, I'm going to go with the Colts to upset the Raiders. Maybe 28-24, nice close game, nice ball control offense for the Colts. If the Jaguars end up getting in, I think I'm going to pick the Jaguars. I don't know. If the Jags can really finish 7-1 with that horrible team, I think he's going to beat the Raiders, and I probably would pick maybe 42-37. So either Jaguars or Colts will be advancing in this game.
Yeah, man. You know, I've seen the Jags. I got some looks at him through some insight. I'm not going to release the sources, but he's going to be scary if he makes it in. Dan, you know, holler at me. I'll let you know what he's running. But, you know, as far as the Colts, I think you deserve it. You know, if the commish had a little heart, he would let you in. But he's not a nice guy sometimes, so nothing I can do. I don't know. It's tough. I don't know. If Jags get in, I think he beats Raiders. Colts get in, I think he might be, I don't know, Dan's been hot lately too, so it's a toss-up. I don't know what's going on until I know the definite teams at this point.
That's going to be a very interesting game, either if it's Raiders-Colts or Raiders-Jags, because all three of those teams are very hot, so that's going to be a great game. And hey, the Colts have to earn their keep, man. You have to win games to get in. Not going to get a freebie by me. So now, look at the NFC side. We got Tampa Bay, 9-7. They're going to be visiting the Carolina Panthers. Looks like the Panthers swept the season series. They won the first game 35-17 Week 9, and they won again Week 15 27-24, and we all know that it's very hard to win three times against an opponent. A lot of people say that, kind of cliche, but I'm going against that. I think the Panthers will win this game. It'll be close. It might be, you know, by a field goal, by a touchdown, but I think the Panthers will win this game, and he will travel right to Washington as soon as that game's over.
Jason, calling you out, bro. This is the time. This is the place. Time to come up. I'm taking you. Mr. Wet in the Diaper himself, I'm taking you in this game. Let's go. Third time's a charm, baby. Let's take it, and let's get it done. I'm taking Jason in this game because he's seen what Cam Newton runs, and he knows. Let's prepare. Run the muscle hamster. Period.
You haven't learned from me. Every time I pick Jason, he loses. And every time you pick him, he loses. So you're going to learn the hard way, it looks like. But you know what? Before I continue, speaking of the expert picks, you had a commanding lead on me going into the last final week. But I pulled ahead of you by three picks. I'm up 86 and 53, and you're 83 and 56. So we're not going to catch the sim games when that happens. So it looks like I might have beat you there in the regular season.
Jack, man, handshake. Hey, that kind of makes up for you not being in the playoffs.
Yeah, like I need something, right? So, all right. So we were here at Detroit at San Francisco, which is a very interesting game. These guys did not play during the season. The Niners finished very hot, winning some big games. The Lions as well. But when it comes down to it, you know, you got to go with the experience. I think MMX has a little more experience than Coach got a sexy wife. I know Ron has a Super Bowl title under his belt, but a lot of people say that he won that when, you know, no one was really in the league after Sweeney retired. But I think the Niners will win this game. It'll be low scoring because that's the kind of game MMX wants to do to you. I'm going to pick maybe 20-13. Very close game, but I think the Niners will come out victorious.
I'm going the other way. I'm going the other way once again. I'm going Lions. I got a sexy wife. You know, he showed me some pictures of the wife, and I'm picking him right now just because he scares me more than MMX does. MMX, I love you. You're a great website guy. But as far as playing, I'll go with the Lions in this one. DJ goes over 200 yards and 2 TDs.
Wow. Okay. Well, that'll do it for the wild card. Looks like, you know, and hopefully tonight, I don't know, I know the Jags are he's going to play another game against the Seahawks tonight. And if he wins that, he's still alive. Hopefully Eric can get on, get his ass online, come out of hiding, and play the Colts because he needs to finish this season out. And hopefully we can have an answer by tonight so we can start these playoffs tomorrow. If not, we might start them over the weekend. So it looks like we have no callers right now. So what I was going to do is break down the yearly award nominees if you want to open that page.
Okay, got you.
And I can't believe no one wants to call in. Pretty ridiculous.
They're scared. I know it.
That's fine. So, right now, looks like the AFC MVP, my favorite is Peyton Manning. His numbers are outstanding. Those numbers aren't accurate if you were to passing standings. He was very close to tying Griffin's record last season, was set by Coach Betts. He had 52 touchdowns this year, Peyton Manning, and 18 picks. About 4,800 yards. Right now, he's my favorite to win the MVP. Of course, you know, there's voting that will happen as soon as the season ends and stay open until the Super Bowl, but right now, I think Peyton Manning is my AFC MVP.
Yeah, Peyton Manning's good. Definitely, Peyton Manning's up there. Denver's a great team. Can't go wrong with them. And nothing I can say, man. He's probably going to be in the Super Bowl versus the Bears unless I think the Jets can beat him, but other than that, I hope he's in the Super Bowl.
All right, and then in the NFC, you got yours truly, but the problem with that is I didn't make the playoffs. So is Peterson's numbers that dominant that to win the MVP? I mean, I had 2,600 yards, 26 touchdowns. It's hard to argue with that, but then you got to look at Griffin, you got to look at Cutler. It's going to be a pretty close MVP race in the NFC. I think Cutler might have broken the QB rating record, but that's something that we have not calculated yet. But I think he's close to breaking that record. RG3, Peterson. It's going to be a close vote, but I think I'm going to go with myself. I'm going to go with Peterson win that MVP. I think people are going to feel sorry for me and vote for me.
Yeah, I'd go with Peterson, you know, because you had nothing else to stuff him, so I kind of feel bad for you. You know, with a little bit better team, you would have been in there, but, you know, you did your best what you could with what you had, so I give you credit for that.
Yeah, thanks a lot. All right, so it looks like we do have a caller. We have two callers on hold. I'm going to go with this first one here. I'm not sure who it is, but let's bring him on. Hey, you're live on the line with MOF Radio. Who's this?
Hey, this is MMX.
MMX, how you doing?
Hey, not bad. I heard Polly downplaying my 49ers, so I had to call in.
Okay, so hey, Polly, go ahead. You can go first, buddy.
Man, I don't know. I'm just not feeling, you know, MMX, you know, he's got, you know, a sexy you-know-what, so I don't know. I'm just not feeling Niners. I don't think you can score enough points, that's all.
Well, let me tell you this, and this is probably going to be locker room fodder for sexy wife, but I beat him 4 times last season. You know how we had the reset season? Beat him twice the first time, beat him twice the second time. And now you're going to go against me? Come on, do your homework.
Wow, I didn't remember that. I forgot that.
Yeah. So, no, I fully expect a good game. Of course, you know, you get Calvin Johnson and you know, you're going to be scared shitless, you know, whenever you go up against him. And I don't know. We'll see how it goes. Just going to go out there and have fun. I really don't expect to get far because if I play the Bears or the Redskins, you know, that's when you can start going against me.
Well, I think he has a better shot against the Redskins, to be honest with you. He's been slipping a little bit. So, I mean, I pick you to beat the Lions, and if you play the Redskins next, I'm going to pick you to pick the Redskins. I'm going to beat you. I think you're going to beat the Redskins, yes. But you know what? You're probably going to play the Bears in the second round and so long.
If I had the Cardinals, I'd be all set for the Super Bowl, but oh well. Actually, you're talking to the only coach to take the Cardinals to the playoffs, and not only did he take them to the playoffs, he took them to the Super Bowl in the same season.
And you know what? You say about Ports, I beat him on the way there, too, so
it's funny you bring that up. I'm probably bringing up bad memories for him, too, if he's listening.
All right, so hey, quick, MX, how's the site looking with the playoff integration?
It's going okay. I mean, there's of course going to be a couple things I need to change up on. It's kind of a fickle thing whenever you're dealing with code and databases. But you know, that's not really good radio show talk. So I'll get off that. It's coming along, and we'll get there. I'm trying to go as quickly as I can between that and a pregnant wife. You know.
No, I understand totally. So. Well, I want to thank you again for all you do for the website. Like I said, if it wasn't for you, MOF would probably be dead by now. So, again, thank you a lot. Thank you very much. Paulie, thank you.
Definitely, man. Congrats, man. Congrats, and good luck with a young son, but I'm still not picking you.
Yes, good luck.
It's okay. I'm always listening, Paulie. Take care, guys.
All right, MX. Take care. All right, so I don't know who else this is right now on the line. Let's bring him through.
Well,
You're live on the phone with MOF Radio.
Most inconsistent baller in MOF history. It's crazy. What's up, guys?
What's going on? Who's this again?
Hey. Josh.
I didn't get that. Who is this?
Josh Nelson.
Yeah.
Oh, Nelson. What's going on, man? How you doing?
Oh, not too bad at all, fellas. Great job on the radio show, man.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah, you know, just the Baltimore Ravens, I'm up 14-0 in Week 17 right now against the Bengals. That's what I'm talking about, the most inconsistent team ever. Yeah, I go from putting a whipping on Dipko, 32-31, to getting destroyed by Pauly.
Talk about that.
Getting destroyed by Pauly twice.
Yeah, man. Oof. I don't know what to say about that, man.
All I got to say, Pauly, is you represent the AFC side, AFC North in the playoffs. Take it home, but I think the true Super Bowl is going to be Washington versus Chicago, the NFC Championship game.
Definitely, yeah, man.
Something else.
Yeah, I agree, man. I agree. You know, I give you much props, man. I give you props. You played a good game. Second game was tight. And, you know, I always love the MOF Fets. You know, you played it tough. As far as the Super Bowl, I think I don't think Skins have a chance, though. You know, I think it's going to be Denver or the Jets versus the Bears.
The Jets,
well,
for real?
Of course, Paulie, you're never going to pick yourself. I mean, that's just that you never do. But I don't think I'm going to pick the Super Bowl just yet. But you know what? I think the AFC Championship, we're going to see Pittsburgh and Denver, NFC, obviously, Chicago, Washington. And then from there, I'll give you my picks. But,
you said obviously.
Josh,
whew.
Yeah,
NFC.
Obviously.
Oh, man.
So, Josh, you're actually calling us and playing at the same time. That's pretty impressive.
Well, like I said, it's Week 17. I got nothing on the line right now, and me and Hova just having fun here in Week 17. So.
And he's playing the Bengals.
Yeah,
that's true. Well, Hova was gone for a while, and he actually didn't play the Chiefs. We had to have a substitute play for the Chiefs, probably for the Bengals against the Chiefs. So I apologize to Hova for that, but I didn't know he was. I didn't even know he was alive, actually. So
he kind of disappeared for a little while, didn't he?
All right, Josh, well, we thank you for calling. We have about 50 seconds left, and if we don't talk to you, good luck in season 24. Hopefully you turn things around.
Absolutely. We'll see you guys next year. I'll go 7-9 again next year.
All right, Josh, thank you.
All right, buddy, you're my boy, man. Take it easy.
All right, so that will conclude MOF Radio Episode 5. Next time you'll hear from us will be next week. Hopefully we have the divisional playoffs all set and ready to go. So, Paulie, thank you again for co-hosting as usual.
No problem, man. It was a pleasure, and you did a great job all year with the website. It was great, man. It was one of the best years of MOF through a lot of adversity, so I give you a lot of props for that, man.
Thank you. I appreciate that. So, all right, Paulie, we'll talk to you next week. And, guys,
good luck in the playoffs. And hopefully the Colts can hang one out there, because I know a lot of people won't be too happy. But all right, guys, good luck in the playoffs, and see you next week.